Asteroids are small rocky fragments left over from the formation of the solar system. Most of these ancient space rocks can be found orbiting the Sun between Mars and Jupiter. Jupiter's massive gravity and occasional close encounters with Mars change the orbits of such asteroids, knocking them out of the main belt and sending them towards Earth. Asteroids have slammed into Earth in the past, playing a major role in altering the geological history of the planet and in the evolution of life on Earth. Scientists continuously monitor asteroids whose paths intersect Earth's orbit. These asteroids are called near-Earth objects, and they may pose an impact danger. According to NASA, an asteroid is classified as a near-Earth object when its distance from our planet is less than 4.6 million miles. Last year, NASA reached a milestone of detecting the 1,000th near-Earth asteroid. Radar is a valuable tool in detecting and monitoring these dangerous asteroids. The radar detection of these fast-moving objects helps astronomers understand their orbits, providing data that can help us predict if an asteroid is going to hit Earth. NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, that tracks space objects, has spotted an asteroid nearly 1.3 kilometers in size heading towards Earth. The potentially hazardous asteroid is said to be up to 4,265 feet wide. This makes it almost three times as big as the Empire State Building. The Empire State Building stands at around 1,453 feet tall, so it would be pale in comparison to this asteroid. This asteroid has been added to the list of potentially hazardous asteroids. The asteroid will make its close approach to Earth on March 4th, coming as close to Earth as 49 million kilometers. The near-Earth asteroid is called 2001 CB21. The asteroid is on its way to complete its orbit around the Sun in just 400 days. At its closest approach to Earth, this space rock will be traveling at a whopping speed of 43,000 kilometers per hour. The last time it came this close to Earth was in 2006, when the asteroid swooped past from a distance of 71 million kilometers. Once the asteroid passes by Earth on March 4th, its next close approach is scheduled in the year 2043, when it will be just 48 million kilometers away from Earth. The orbital forecast has been released by the Center for Near-Earth Object Studies. The agency has also released the orbit of the asteroid for its March 4th approach with Earth. While NASA has released the orbit, astronomer Gianluca Massi at the Virtual Telescope Project in Italy managed to capture the object floating in the vacuum of space, hurtling towards us. Using a land-based telescope, he captured the asteroid when it was nearly 35 million kilometers away from Earth. The asteroid was first spotted by the Near-Earth Asteroid Research Program, which has been responsible for more than 24% of the discoveries of all known potentially hazardous asteroids. The program has reported more than 14 million observations of asteroids and comets, and has found 6,000 new objects. Some experts are worried that Earth isn't yet ready to defend itself from deadly asteroids. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk once sparked concern by tweeting, "A big rock will hit Earth eventually and we currently have no defense." While this is not entirely true, as NASA has a plan to stop asteroids from hitting Earth. NASA recently launched its DART mission. This is the first ever mission of asteroid deflection by changing an asteroid's motion in space through kinetic impact. DART, which stands for Double Asteroid Redirection Test, is supposed to lay the groundwork to change that. It's NASA's first ever planetary defense mission. The plan is simple: aim for one of these near-Earth asteroids and crash into it. If the DART spacecraft can alter the speed of the asteroid, even by a millimeter per second, it will change its orbit. In the hypothetical case of an asteroid hurtling toward Earth, a slight orbital shift could be the difference between an awkward flyby and an extinction. There's also the possibility of blowing the asteroid with a nuclear weapon. The nuclear option could come into play if the dangerous space rock is too big to knock around with a kinetic impactor, but it would likely be a weapon of last resort. For one thing, blasting an asteroid to bits might end up doing more harm than good.